Hey everyone, welcome back. Today, we're diving into an essential topic for anyone starting a new database project with SurrealDB. Schemafull versus schemaless databases. We'll break down what these terms mean, how to use them in SurrealDB, and when to choose one over the other. Let's get started. When kicking off a new database project, one of the first steps is defining your schema. But what exactly is a schema? A schema defines the structure and organization of your data. It determines how data is stored, organized, and manipulated, specifying tables, fields, data types, constraints, and relationships between tables. Essentially, it's the blueprint for ensuring your data behaves as expected. There are two main types of schemas: Schemafull, which is structured, and schemaless, which is unstructured. A schemafull database requires you to define your data structure upfront. This includes specifying tables and fields. It's great for applications with well-defined data models because it enforces consistency and integrity. In SurrealDB, you can use the define statement for a schemafull approach. Here's how you can create a schemafull table. First, we define a table using the define table statement. The schemafull keyword in the statement shows that this is a schemafull table. Next, we define fields using the define field statement for each field on the user table. The assert clause here ensures that the email field contains a valid email address. Now let's populate this table using the create statement. If you try to add an invalid email, SurrealDB will return an error because it doesn't meet the assert condition. This can be used to validate any restrictions you want on a field. In the example above, the string is email function is used to check whether the value is an email. In a schemafull table, since the fields need to be defined before you can populate them, if you add data to a field that doesn't exist, you will get back an error. For example, in the user table, you have only defined the first name, last name, and email fields. If you introduce a photo URI field without defining the field in the user table, it will return an error. Now let's take a look at setting up a table in schemaless mode. A schemaless database doesn't require predefined structures, offering flexibility for dynamic and evolving data models. This is ideal for applications dealing with diverse data formats. In SurrealDB, you can create a schemaless table directly using data definition statements like create or update. Here's an example using the create and update statements. Using the create statement, we can add an IC directory table where the object ID contains the username and full name. The ID can be anything you want, and if not defined, is randomly generated. In SurrealDB, the table name and ID together is called a record ID. Now let's use the update statement to create a table. For example, to make a manager directory which has Jane Smith as the ID. You can see here that we've linked the manager directory to the corresponding IC directory using the record IDs in the manager and report fields respectively. You can also define a schemaless table explicitly using the define table statement with the schemaless clause. In a schemaless table, you can add new fields on the fly without predefining them. For example, in the user table, you can introduce a metadata field to store the date a user was created, even if it's not a defined field. SurrealDB allows you to mix both schemafull and schemaless approaches within the same project. This flexibility is perfect for applications like customer relationship management systems, otherwise known as CRMs, where you might want structured data for customer details and orders, but need flexible data handling for customer interactions and feedback. To wrap up, deciding between schemafull and schemaless depends on your application's requirements. Use schemafull tables for structured data with strict validation, and schemaless tables for dynamic evolving data. Combining both approaches allows you to leverage the strengths based on your needs. For more detailed information, check out the Define Statement documentation. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more tutorials. See you in the next one.